We three kings of Orient are, bearing gifts we traverse afar, field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light.
Angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains,
and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains.
Glory in excelsis Deo.
Just hear those sleigh bells jingling, ring ting tingling too. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Outside the snow is falling and friends are calling you. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Giddy-up, 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 let's go. Let's look at the show. We're riding in a wonderland of snow. Come on, horsey. Giddy up, giddy.
Christmas bells. Thank you.
Shall
Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day rule the nation?
Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? This sleeping child
hey! fix?
Said you never got fixed.
I got some preachers, more for that stood at the door. Preaching in Hebrew, chilling, two for calling, silence, one for the little baby, baby.
Hello?
I have notes to make sure I don't forget anything. First of all, you having a nice time? Because, I mean, these are the best kids we got. We didn't leave any of the good ones somewhere else. So if you're not enjoying yourself now, this is it, right? I hope you are enjoying it. This is our symphony orchestra ensemble, and I'm Doug Elmore, the orchestra director here. It's a combination of kids from our period 7 strings class and a gathering of wind and percussion players from both the period 7 and period 6 bands who very kindly give up their Wednesday afternoons to rehearse and prepare the music and then join the string players to play. I want to give brief shout outs to two very close friends of mine that helped me with this. General music and band teacher Paul Shepherd from Highland Hills Middle School coaches all of these wind players every Wednesday for us. And she is not here this evening. She was here last night. Miss Courtney Rains from Highland Hills Middle School comes in every period 7 and works with us and coaches our second violins and first violins in sectional. So I'd like to give her a thank you as well. Now there's four items of business that we must attend to in a pretty quick time. So I'm going to talk to you. Be attentive. You won't want to miss a thing, I promise. First of all, you just said you're having a good time, you're enjoying this. But the youth of America have worked very hard to give you a wonderful musical presentation tonight, and they are delivering on that, which is great, because if you feel that strongly about it, in a minute you're going to get to prove it. We're about to go into intermission, and in intermission there is a silent auction in the lobby. And a lot of people think your heart is right here. I don't think that. I think your heart is in here. So when you go out in the lobby at intermission, dig into your heart and show how much you enjoyed this by bidding on silent auction items, because all of the money made at the silent auction helps our band, our orchestra, our choir, our handbells, and our jazz band continue to work hard and strive for excellence every day. And that's what we want for our children, right? To strive for excellence? You can say. So make sure when you go out there you bid enthusiastically and from the heart, which I already told you where your heart's located. Now, I've also been asked to remind you that if you enjoy this music, you can buy in the lobby an enduring keepsake of this performance, a CD with all of this music recorded on it. There's a booth right out there. They're doing sales tonight. You can get it at intermission or I think after the show as well. They take cash, they take checks, they take cards. So if you're enjoying this music and you would like a record of it to play on your CD player, for those of us that still have CD players, it's out in the lobby. Now, there's an annoying tradition that I started about 15 years ago with this. It would not be a winter fantasia without a few dry Christmas jokes. Now, the first one I found has very close tie-ins to the cold and flu season. What do they use in the North Pole to ward off infections? Hand sanitizer. Sanitizer. Oh, just wait, they get better. Now, everybody knows the story of Santa and his sleigh and how they fly around and give toys to all the good little children in the road. It's an amazing sleigh, and I've often wondered, well, how much did he pay for that sleigh? Nothing. It was on the house. And if you think about Santa's employees, the elves, they work really hard to make toys for all of the children every year, and they like to listen to music when they work. What do they listen to? Rap music. W-R-A-P. Rap. And this will be the last one. Good one. I'll see you in the lobby. There were three wise men that visited the manger scene. And the third wise man stepped up. And what did the third wise man say after his friends presented the frankincense and the gold? He said, but wait, there's myrrh. So. Circle this thing around and park it again. This next tune is the last tune of the first half, and when you go to the lobby, bid from the heart. All jokes aside, this is a big night for us. We've worked very hard to bring these four shows to the community. You do us honor by showing up to listen to these magnificent young people. However, stuff like this doesn't happen without funding and without the support of the community. So thank you in advance for that. Now, the last tune of this half is Leroy Anderson's famous orchestra piece, Sleigh Ride. which we've all heard a lot as we've grown up in America. And Leroy Anderson actually was a really serious concert composer. He wrote a lot of what I call legit music, and then he wrote several pop orchestra pieces that just became instant classics. People love them. This was premiered by the Boston Symphony, I think, back in the 1930s. And it's not an easy piece. It's easy to get burnt playing Sleigh Ride. You have to be well prepared to play it. It takes serious effort to play it. And to respect and honor that serious effort that we have to give to this, we have decided to attire ourselves in the most serious way possible. So if you'll give us a second, we will prepare ourselves to play this. Thank you.
Thank you. Try to make all of our transitions to where most things happen while something else is performing, but we can't do that here because we have all of our stuff to move. So this is a good time for me to thank several people who are making this happen that you don't see. We have several alums and students who are doing the technical side of things for us tonight. Lighting design was done by alum Michael Nevitt. Our audio design is done by an alum, Rob Payne. Our recordings tonight, which you, if you have not already seen, there's a table out in the lobby where you can order audio recordings of our performance. Our recordings being done also by another alum, Jordan Berger. And then we have a whole host of students that I'm getting ready to name, but they are headed up by our technical theater director here at Floyd Central, who is also an alum, Jared Willis. Students helping us out tonight are Jeff Wagner, Maggie Smallwood, Bailey Gilbert, Eli Meese, Grace Coddington, Junior Jones, and Indy Puckett. You don't see all of these people, but we could not do this without them. Would you please give them a round of applause? I would also like to thank all of our parent volunteers. We have our ushers came from orchestra parents, ticket assistants came from choir parents, band parents are doing the, are running the auction out in the lobby. We have had several parents that have helped with things along the way in prep for tonight as well. And additionally, our performing arts admin assistant, Susan Wagner, who many of you spoke with when you bought your tickets, I'm imagining. Please give all of them a round of applause. What you're seeing tonight is mostly students doing their thing, but we truly could not do what we do with the students if it weren't for all the volunteers that we have, from our parents to just all of our helpers that have given us assistance throughout this process. Looks like we are ready to continue with the accidentals.
Thank you. We're going to take a few minutes here to move most of Floyd County onto the stage. We have over 400 students that are going to be joining us for the last part of the program, and it's very exciting, so give us just a moment to relax, and the colleague will be with you soon. Thank you. Thank you.
exciting to watch, right? There's quite a bit of maneuvering that has to happen yet, so I thought I would engage you in a little bit of a historical authenticity here. This is what we like to call the mass set, or as I personally like to call it, that moment when I engage in silent prayer standing on a box by myself. There are over 400 performers on stage, and they're going to play three tunes for you. One, two of them were expressly written for festival organizations like this, groups of high schoolers coming together. Do You Hear What I Hear? And White Christmas are expressly designed for gatherings of students like this. The Hallelujah Chorus was written for a much smaller ensemble of top-flight professionals and a very well-trained, tight choir working in a medium church-sized space. So we are straining the bounds of the possible to do this. However, the students have done some truly remarkable work to prepare this, and so I'm very excited at what they're about to launch when everyone is in position. I had a long story for you about the tradition of people standing during the Hallelujah Chorus. However, I'm trying to shave a few minutes off of my talking tonight, so you'll just have to Google that story when you get home tonight. So, in a moment, you will hear the mass set. Thank you.
Thank you all for coming out tonight so much. On behalf of my colleagues, Angela Hampton, Doug Elmore, and Kristen Hanschel, thank you for rejoining us back here in the auditorium. Thank you to Jared Willis and the Theater Tech people for all the beautiful display they have here that gives the atmosphere that we weren't able to have last year if we were in the gymnasium. I'm sort of interested, how many people, this is your first Winter Fantasia? Thank you for clapping up there because I can't see the light. Thank you. Welcome, and I hope you have enjoyed it, and we'll come back again and again and again. I know a lot of people, this is sort of the kickoff for the holiday season for everyone. It's great that we're able to get over 400 students. It's close to 23% of the school is actually on stage right now performing for you. And getting. And each one of them is important, is as important as the next. It's everybody working together for you, you giving back to them here immediately. It's a wonderful experience. We had past few years, it's been unusual, but it's great to get back to this because playing music for people live is why we're here. That's why we have education in schools and why these students have dedicated a big part of their lives to playing their instruments and singing and being here for you. So thank you once again for coming here. We're going to end the program tonight with White Christmas, and it's been around since Georgetown High School. Are there any Georgetown High School graduates here? They may have been in the choir. We're getting fewer and fewer of those. It's been a while since Georgetown was here, but it's been around a long time in this area to end our concert with White Christmas, and we hope that you were able to take this feeling and take it with you as you go through the holiday season. Thank you very much for being here. White Christmas.